Well, Republic TV is tracking the story very, very closely, and the story is getting more and more mysterious. We have now accessed a document which shows how Rahul Gandhi exited as the director at Backops India, and his sister Priyanka Vadra was made a director in the Backops mysterious firm. Republic TV's Shavan Sen has accessed that document, and he will be joining us live with the document on Priyanka Vadra's name now being seen in the Backops mystery. She was made a director in Backops India. There was no clarity on Priyanka Vadra's role in this firm. Backops is in the news because Rahul Gandhi was a director in that firm. Rahul Gandhi had declared himself as a British citizen when he applied for company-related correspondence with the UK government. And Shavan is joining us live because this Backops mystery is getting bigger, Shavan. Priyanka Vadra being made the director of Backops, a firm where Rahul Gandhi in UK, in the UK arm, was in touch also. I mean, the other director was Ulrik McKnight, who later benefited from this Scorpene deal, is what we are being told. At least that's the charge, the allegation. But what is Priyanka's role in Backops as we know it so far, Shavan?
Well, what's important to point out here is that once this particular company in 2002, when it was incorporated in India, we're given to understand that Rahul Gandhi basically transferred the entire ownership of this company to Backhouse Private Limited to Priyanka Gandhi, as well as a close family friend. And a year later, you have another operation being started in United Kingdom with his partner called Ulrik McKnight. Now, we've been able to access all papers related to this company. There are a web of companies, Niranjan, and to put this in perspective, where exactly comes the defense deal? Because this defense deal was with a French company called DCNS with a Vishakhapatnam-based company called Flash Forge India Private Limited. You have a $4.5 billion deal that was basically struck in 2011, and the company was supposed to give India 6 submarines. Now, Ulrik McKnight, we see that soon after this particular deal, there have been a web of companies that were basically floated in United Kingdom. And finally, the papers that we have, and I'll just want to start off with company number one to explain it to our viewers, where does this link essentially emerge? It starts with this particular company called company number one, which is Optimal Armor Limited, a company incorporated in 2012. Let's go to the second company, which is basically Composite Reason Development Limited in 2013. Now, interestingly, both these companies have a link with Flash Forge Private Limited, the offset partner of DCNS. And what is surprising is that directors of both these companies happen to be Ulrik McKnight. Finally, this company has been taken over by Flash Forge India Private Limited, making Ulrik McKnight as one of the board members of the offset partner of DCNS. So now clearly there is a link that essentially emerges where you have DCNS's offset partner, which happens to be the Flash Forge Private Limited, where you have Ulrik McKnight as one of the directors. So that particular link has already been established. Now, as far as quid pro quo is concerned, remember, that's a matter of investigation, and investigative agencies already suggesting that Ulrik McKnight has been traveling to India quite frequently. In fact, he has an Indian connection. He's been married to one of the Congress leaders' daughter, we are given to understand, and there have been frequent traveling between United Kingdom as well as United States of America and India. In fact, the Backops operations, which basically started in 2002, we are given to understand that Ulrik McKnight was also looking after these operations. Interesting to point out here, Niranjan, is that soon after Backops Private Limited was incorporated in India, Rahul Gandhi gave an interview to a news website saying that this is a small company looking into the back-end operations of few companies operating out of USA as well as United Kingdom. But it now turns out that through web of companies, you have Rahul Gandhi's partners' hands in certain defense deals. And also, Niranjan, I'd like to tell our viewers that we are going to come out with some more information, which is going to be extremely shocking, because the nature of these companies is not limited to defense production in itself. That in itself is going to be yet another revelation, which we are certainly working on. And it's going to be something that Rahul Gandhi certainly needs to answer, because Ulrik McKnight's companies are not just linked with defense production, but several other in several other manufacturing units, which raises more questions.
Yeah, you know, just checking if we have the flowchart here, and you know, we'll just I just want to tell our viewers about this flowchart that we were talking about, Shavan. Shavan, the flowchart that we spoke about, Backops UK, for all our viewers who are watching this story, here's how the story unfolds, and we'll tell you the entire web and how the web is stitched together. This is the web, and we'll just put that out on the screen, and we will explain it to our viewers. So there is a company called Backops UK, and Republic TV brought you that document. In Backops UK, there are two directors. One is Rahul Gandhi, the other is Ulrik McKnight, the mysterious Ulrik McKnight. Now, here's where the mystery unfolds. Backops UK, the director is Ulrik McKnight, along with Rahul Gandhi. The company is dissolved. And then what happens is, Backops becomes composite resin. So this Ulrik McKnight then is a director at composite resin. Backops becomes composite resin. And that this company is being bought out by Flash Forge. So Backops to composite resin. Composite resin is another company floated by Rahul Gandhi's business partner. And Flash Forge is a company that gets the Scorpene offsets. Scorpene offsets valued at nearly 20,000 crore rupees. The deal is valued at 20,000 crore rupees. The offsets is backed by a company called Flash Forge. What Flashforge does is that it acquires composite resin. It acquires composite resin. And not just that, here's the connection. Flashforge, the company that is dealing with Scorpene directly, the offsets of Scorpene directly, makes a joint venture with a company called Koyat, partners with a firm linked with Scorpene called Neridis, and then acquires another company, Mystery. Mystery because it acquires another company, two companies it's acquiring. One company is Composite Resin. The second company it acquires is called Optimal Armor. Optimal Armor is a company where the director, once again, mysteriously, was a man called Ulrik McKnight, Rahul Gandhi's partner. Rahul Gandhi's partner, Ulrik McKnight's firm, is bought by the same company that has the Scorpene offsets. And then later, Optimal Armor, where Ulrik McKnight was a director, that firm is also bought out by Flashforge. It is also bought out by Flashforge. And then, this is the story. Flashforge is the company that gets the Scorpene offset. So, simply put, all of this is happening under UPA. Rahul Gandhi's business partner, bought out by the company that got the Scorpene offset. And I think that's the full story and that's the allegation, isn't it, Shavan? One of quid pro quo. How is it that Rahul Gandhi, Rahul Gandhi's business partners, Rahul Gandhi's friends were getting the offsets under UPA regime? Isn't that the question? Shavan.
Well, as far as quid pro quo is concerned, this is a matter of investigation and some... looking at Optimal Armor Private Limited, Composite Resin Development. These are companies in the first place when the merger essentially took place. Questions were raised because A, the fact that these companies do not have, they have certain liabilities. Despite that, they were taken, there was a merger that took place. Then you have, look at the timing of the deal being struck in 2011, then you have multiple companies basically being formed, and mysteriously you have Ulrik McKnight as a director in all these companies, finally leading to Ulrik McKnight becoming a board member of Flash Forge Private Limited, the offset partner of DCNS. So that's one big question that is essentially being raised, that loss-making companies, how is it that a merger takes place, and finally that benefits Ulrik McKnight. That is something that one is looking into. Secondly, as far as quid pro quo is concerned, remember what's very important is that after this particular deal was struck in 2011, this particular deal came under fire because of a leak that took place in 2016. All of these companies are now under the lens of the Ministry of Defense, because remember, this led to a huge controversy because the submarine project's details were basically leaked, which is reported by an Australian newspaper, and thereafter questions were basically raised whether at all national security was compromised. At that point in time, we were given to understand that investigative agencies were not only looking at the leak per se, but also the link with other companies, these offset companies which were in place, and also the financial dealings of these companies. They were all under the scanner. What is still not known at this point in time, whether at all investigative agencies have filed an official complaint, because given the fact that there have been certain dubious transactions that have essentially taken place, that is something that the investigative agencies perhaps would throw more light upon at a later stage. But clearly, questions are being raised essentially because of the way Ulrik McKnight figures in this entire deal.
Shavan, in fact, the Prime Minister has also raised this. This is going to be a very, very, very big story. Broken on Republic TV, and Shavan Shen getting all the details and the papers and the documents. Story is getting bigger. The Prime Minister has also raised it. Rahul Gandhi, who was questioning offsets in Rafael, didn't have much meat. Lost the steam. And we're getting in some now breaking news that Arun Jaitley, Union Minister, is expected to hold a news conference at 4 p.m. That's big breaking news. We're also expecting a big expose. We're being told it's going to be an explosive news conference at 4 p.m. We're just building up to that. Shavan, hearing that the government and Minister Arun Jaitley will hold a news conference, just breaking that update now, Aishwarya getting us that detail of the government escalating the fight against the Gandhis. Now, we just have to wait and watch whether it will be linked to this controversy. But from the Prime Minister to the BJP President, now hearing that Arun Jaitley will also hold a news conference on this matter, where we are expecting a big, big expose on the Backops mystery and how Rahul Gandhi's business partner got or benefited from the Scorpene deal, because it was a firm link to Rahul's business partner that backed the Scorpene offsets link. The government going all out against the Congress president, raising questions on Rahul Gandhi and his links to this man who got the Scorpene offsets valued at over 20,000 crore rupees. Aishwarya, are we expecting the Union Minister to perhaps throw more details or respond to what's already out in the public domain?
Niranjan, what we can confirm, that it's going to be a massive expose. It is going to be an expose about information which is not there still in out there in the public. It's going to be a massive expose at 4 p.m. when Finance Minister Arun Jaitley is going to hold that press conference. There are going to be more documents. There is going to be more proof, and dots are going to be joined in. Where exactly was Mr. Ulrik living in London? What is the connection? How are they connected? And how Rahul Gandhi exits and Priyanka Gandhi enters there, but why? Why Backops? And why only in 2009? Why did the whole concentration of Backops move from London to Delhi? And what was the connection between Rahul, Priyanka and Ulrik? So all of this can be exposed. That is what we are being indicated by our sources, that it's going to be a massive expose by Arun Jaitley at 4 p.m. at the BJP headquarters when he does that press conference. And they're also being told that there are going to be more documents, when we here at Republic are going to get you those documents first and prior, Niranjan. But what we are being confirmed, there is going to be more explosive information and documents coming out, and we'll be the first to get you those, where we are being told that controversy over Rahul's partner and the connections of those partners. The connections of those partners are more important, Niranjan. When we say that Rahul exists and Priyanka enters, it's not only about the Gandhis, it's also about the co-partners, it's also about the partners which have been given benefits, it's also about the connections of those partners, it's about their offices and who held those premises in foreign land. The indication is clear, Niranjan, that who were those individuals who held those very lands which were then given to these companies where Rahul Gandhi and Ulrik were partners, who were holding those lands in overseas land, in overseas area. All of this can come out in the expose at 4 p.m. That's going to be a massive, massive expose in action where you're going to see it.
Taking a short break at this point, Aishwarya's story is getting bigger. The Scorpene, Rahul link getting bigger. Priyanka Vadra, also a director at Backops. 4 p.m., we're expecting some explosive details as a minister holds a news conference. We'll take a short break. We'll be back with the details. Stay with you.